In my last video I demonstrated how to develop cylinder or cone surfaces, and we have the problem that we cannot develop a sphere surface. So we have still the problem how to create a model, a paper model of a sphere or of a part which is derived from a sphere, for example such one. And the only thing what we can do is we can approximate such a surface by some cones. And I have created a new node. I call it the Apfelsin node, because it's the task to create a development of the surface of an orange. And orange in Germany is also, we also use the word Apfelsin, which is apple from China. And so this node is the Apfelsin node. Okay, what is the idea? I start with half of the sphere, this one. And what we can do is we can look for such a stripe, for such a subface, and if this subface, this ring, is small enough, we can approximate it with a cylinder, and we can develop it, and the result is something like this. That means we see here this area, we see here this gap. And if we print these lines on a paper and we cut it and we connect it here with these two lines, we get this this area here. And this is now the model. I have here the Apfelsin node with some parameters. I use here the coordinates, the longitude and the latitude to describe the position on the sphere. And I also can use a latitude list. But let's start with this example. In this example, I say here longitude min is minus 180 degree. And the max is 180 degree. We can say this is 180 degree to the west, and this is 180 degree to the east, if we use Earth coordinates. And we have here for the latitude a minimum of 30 degrees. This is here. Here we have the equator with 0 degree, we have the North Pole with 90 degrees, and we have here this area 30 to 60 degrees. This is this one, and we get the result here. And I can change the values, and I see this development is parametric, and we see if I make this value smaller, this area goes down, and we get here this gap. This is this area here. And also we see here this special figure. We get we have here one hole and here another hole, and if I change the value and go more down, then this figure changes, and now we are under this value, and we see now here the surface is closed. And we also can do it in the other direction. The problem is if I use here a large difference, then this model is bad. It's not a good approximation. So the better way is to have here only small differences. So okay, in this case I come into this area where the my starting surface is cut it here. This is one way we can do. And the other way, what we can do is we can use instead of one stripe, multiple stripe, I use a latitude list. And if I do this, I have here a list of such latitudes. I have the values 0, this is the equator, 10, 20, 30, and 60. And then all these dates are used here to create multiple stripes. And I execute it. So, and we see the result here. Let's look at our model. With these values, I have this split of the sphere. We see here we have, in this case, four stripes. One, two, three, four stripes. And we have here the development, the first stripe, second stripe, third stripe, and the last stripe. And if we print it out on paper, we can cut these stripes and we can bring them together, and we see this point is real, is mapped to this point and this to that one. This is here in the model, these two points. This area we see here, the hole becomes wider. This is this area here becomes wider, and we have here a hole. This is on that side, and so we can calculate the hole system. And I can refine it as I want. Okay, I have the possibility, it depends on the size of my model, how large these stripes are. In this case, I have four stripes, but I can use more or less stripes. So on this way, I can develop every spherical surface. I can approximate the development of a spherical surface and can create a paper model. The Apfelsine node will go into the PyFlow library of high-level nodes next days after some documentation and refinement of the code.